I know as a designer, I've never worked harder than when I do on Terry's films. You know, even when we're doing nothing, it's just complete concentration. But I feel protected in a way that I will never fail, because Terry won't let you fail.
When I work with Terry, I don't feel like I'm working on a movie that's going to come and go in 6 weeks in a theater. I feel like I'm working on something that's going to endure.
I suspect a lot of images he remembers from his childhood. And, you know, big tables or oversized furniture or big rooms or tiny rooms, that these are things that help make up Terry. And they may or may not be part of our background. If they are, we're going to appreciate them differently. If they're not, we'll, you know, we may be introduced to something wondrous.
A centerpiece of the movie, I always felt, was that tree in the yard. And I wanted the family to almost look like they grew out of that yard in Smithville with the tree. And I tried to keep the colors very organic and muted, like in nature.
Sometimes the simplest sets are just as exciting. You know, or the things that you find. I've learned over the years that locations are just as important as sets. That if you find a location that's right, don't change it. We shot at Reimer's Ranch, which was the leftover set from the Alamo. Wonderful $11 million set that's in decay now. Terry loved the decay, and he loved the phoniness of a set. You know, he never wanted to hide that it was a set. I mean, the hardest thing, I think, for a designer is to hold back, you know, not to, you know, put his imprint on stuff. But I've learned, and I think some of this I learned from Terry, is to appreciate the things that are around you. And if you look, you'll find them.
He calls me a method costumer. He says I really am like, you know, really attack characters and how I dress them from the inside out, which is a real compliment. For Brad, we light on this one photo I found of some, actually NASA engineers in Texas. And they were all in soft, muted gabardines, and it was windy, and their pants and shirts were all blowing, and there was a softness to it. Even though he was suited, he was still a musician and a pianist, and he, I felt in all of that rigidity of his character, there was still a soft side that I wanted to come through in his wardrobe.
That's one of the things I respect about Terry. The elements that he mixes together are ones that you never think of maybe putting side by side. And that creates a sense of sort of wonderment, or does something to you that you don't even understand. And I think that everybody will see it a little differently depending on, you know, the colors that they're bringing to it. That it's not going to be the same for you as it is for me, or it is for Terry.